Hi everyone, Scott Harvey here, instructional designer at Hack. Today we are going to be looking at using the Calendly tool for students to schedule appointments to meet with you. Instead of providing students with a floating day and time or an open Zoom link for office hours, you can instead link your Calendly account to your D2L course, where students can simply sign up for an available time slot to meet with you. From there, Calendly will email the appointment details to both you and the student, helping to eliminate the back and forth emails of planning a meeting time. Let's get started. First, you will head to Calendly.com. There, you will click on this blue sign up button to create a new and free account. Enter your Hack email address into this Enter Your Email text box, and click Sign Up. Follow the prompts to finalize your account. For this next step, select your available hours and days. You will be able to further customize your availability later on. Next, choose your day-to-day role. I'm going to select Education, then click Finish. You can choose one of these pre-made events if you prefer. To create your own event, click on this plus new event type button. Click on the blue Create button next to the type of meeting you'd like to create. Since I would be using this as office hours with students, I'm going to select the one-on-one option. Give your event type a name, such as office hours. Click on the drop-down menu under location to choose a location for this meeting type. I'm going to select the Zoom option. You will see here that the option is in red with a warning below reading that Zoom is not connected. Click on the blue link that reads Zoom integration page to connect to your Zoom account. Click on the blue Connect Zoom button. Click on Sign In with SSO to log into Zoom. Once your Zoom account is connected to your Calendly account, the warning will no longer appear. Give a description of this event type if you prefer. You may also change the event type color down here. Click Next. Under Date Range, Invitees Can Schedule, choose how far into the future students can schedule a meeting time with you. This first option allows you to choose either a certain amount of calendar days or business days into the future that students can schedule. If you choose this second option, within a date range, you can type a specific date range into this text box. Students will then be able to choose a meeting time within a set date range that may cover the entire semester or just the course of finals week, whatever you prefer. This third option, indefinitely into the future, will allow students to schedule their meeting with you at any time into the future. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to choose this first option and make it so students can schedule an appointment 30 calendar days into the future. Down here under Duration, choose how long each appointment will last. I'm going to select 30 minutes. Under the How do you want to offer your availability for this event type question, choose either Use an existing schedule, which will use the schedule you created when initially creating your account, or Set custom hours to further customize your availability. If you chose the second option, you can set your custom hours down here. Down here under the Want to add time before or after your events question, choose to have buffer time either before the event or after. You can then choose the amount of buffer time you would like. This will make it so that students cannot sign up for an appointment time either right after or right before a peer's scheduled time. This will be if you need time to prepare for your next meeting. Click Next. You will be directed to a summary page for your event. Click this back button. This will take you back to your Calendly dashboard. The rest of my meetings here are grayed out as this is a free account. Free accounts allow you to only work with one meeting type at a time. To change your active event, you will click on this gear icon on the active event, which will be the one in color. From this list, you can either click delete to get rid of this event for good, or you can hit this on-off switch to switch this one off. Then you can click on this turn on button for the event type you want active. Once you have your preferred event type turned on, click on this blue copy link. Now, the link to this active event is copied and is ready to go into your D2L course. The best place for this link to go is your Instructor Contact widget. If you do not have one already made, check out the Creating an Instructor Contact widget and adding it to your D2L homepage video that is linked to the end of this one. Click on the down arrow of the widget and click Edit this widget. Click on the Content tab. Click on the Insert Quick Link icon. Scroll down the list and select URL. Paste the copied link in the URL box. In the title box, type in something like sign up for an office hour appointment here, or see office hours by clicking here. Anything that will make it clear to the students what this link is for. Click the blue Insert button. Click Save and Close. Now let's take a look at what the student sees when they schedule an appointment. The student will log into the course, find your Instructor Contact widget, and click on the link. They will be taken to this calendar. Available days will be in blue. After the student clicks on the day that they prefer to meet, a list of available times will appear. The student will select a preferred time and will then click Confirm. They will provide their name and their hack email address. They will then click on the blue Schedule Event button. Both you and the student will then receive an email containing the event details and the Zoom link. A calendar invitation will also be made and added to your Outlook calendar. That's how to use Calendly to schedule office hour appointments for your students. Instead of emailing students back and forth to determine a time to meet, save time by creating a Calendly account and linking your event to your D2L course. If you need any help with this or anything else related to D2L, Zoom, or remote instruction, please reach out to anyone on the CDI team. Thank you.